I started going to Tipton Sport Academy 12 months ago to join the activities with the ladies because I'm going to do the London Marathon. I heard really good reports about the academy and the staff are very supportive and I'm really happy I've joined. I wanted to do some training, not being one for pounding the streets. I thought I would look somewhere where I could run and train with other people. When I mentioned I was doing the London Marathon, I've been really supportive. Especially John, the manager, Hayley, and Marva, the fitness coach, they've all been a real great help.
Hi, I'm Hayley. I'm the junior fitness instructor here at Tipton Sports Academy. When I first met Linda, the first thing I need to do is conduct a health assessment. That's where I'll do a weight, the body fat, a height, the blood pressure, and a waist-hip ratio, just to make sure everything's in good working order before we start with the program. Linda told me she wanted to complete the London Marathon, so I've been working alongside with her, setting her a personal program to help her achieve that, taking step by step and increasing it gradually each week. I stay alongside Linda the majority of the time, just to offer a bit of motivation and encourage her to keep going. Today I went up on the track with her and Marva and did a bit of running, a bit of interval training to help build her up to complete the London Marathon.
I feel so fortunate that I've joined the academy and I'll continue to come after I've done the marathon. I join in with quite a few activities once a week, run the track and also use the gym. I like exploring other activities as well, such as badminton, and I like to watch what others are doing as well. I'm willing to have a go at anything, but it's a track and gym for me at the moment. I did the London Marathon for the first time in 2006, and unfortunately after 23 miles I fell over. It had been raining and I broke my thumb. I hadn't realised until I got back home, but carried on to finish. It took me over 7 hours to complete, and I think that's because I fell over really, because I was aiming to put a bit less, but I felt really proud to do things for the charities and I'm helping again this year. I said I wouldn't do it again, but to change my mind, because it's Olympic year, I really wanted to have another go at it. I'm really looking forward to it. Because I've got a Golden Bond place, I've pledged to raise £1,200. And already I've raised £1,050, so I've just got £150 thereabouts to still raise. Ever since I was young, I've been fairly fit and active and used to be a junior javelin thrower, and I was junior javelin champion at Stafford too, which I was really proud of when I was only about 16. A few years on I felt I just wanted to do a bit more, and I was always been interested in the Olympics and watching it on telly, and I thought, what could I do to achieve something like that? I knew I'd never be in the Olympics, so I thought the next thing to that is the London Marathon, and that was the first big one I did, and I really really enjoyed it. Since then I've done Race for Life, the Newcastle North Run, I've also done the Birmingham Half Marathon, Diabetes UK, the Santa Run of Christmas, and 3 miles for Comic Relief, which was at the start of this year. At the moment, I've got my name down for also for the RMB Walkathon, then the Beacon Radio 10-mile run, and also another 2 Race for Lights. I also enjoy doing things for charity, and I've done for quite a while now. It inspires me to see a lot of what's done on television. I've got osteoporosis myself in the spine. I'm also a diabetic. I don't let myself go. I just like to do lots of things. I want to be fit and active and inspire others by showing people if I can do it, they can do it. My final preparation 3 weeks before the marathon is to stop panicking, stop worrying so much and believe in myself and say, I'm going to do it. I think and hope I've done nearly enough training, but I will do a little bit more before the big day. I need to calm down a little bit in the final week and just look forward to the day and come back with a medal. And I've enjoyed it basically, but most importantly, made lots of money for the charity I support. I would like to thank everyone at Tipton Sports Academy for helping me, especially Marva. who does the track star. She has been really supportive. And when I come back with my medal, they will be the first ones, or the first ones to see it.